Hello, Summoners, and we are back in the week 2 of Lenovo LCL Spring 2017 Challenge What You Know.
Challenge What You Know, indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, ang galing lamang tayo sa labat ikalawang panalo. Wow, ah.
Wow.
Talagang sulit na sulit.
2-0.
Oh, ng Malayan Colleges of Laguna Warlocks as they bag in their second victory against
Bicol University.
Shave. Now, Bicol University, after that defeat mula sa Malayan Colleges of
close
Laguna.
Call. Close call.
Actually, it's a close game. Oh, it's a close game, clearly. Dun sa game na yon. It's just that they really got caught off guard dun sa last team fight.
Oh, yeah, kumbaga kung sino yung nagdala nung in the middle of the fight. Siya pa yung medyo, alam mo na, the pressure would be the best friend.
What caught them off guard really is when they allow themselves to be poked down and whittled down in the siege na dun sa mid lane, tsaka, yeah, in the mid lane lang eh, kasi nag-split po si Yorick dun sa bottom lane. And, yun, by that time, just because merong Baron buff, yung Malayan Colleges, yung Warlocks. Pero ito kasi mga kaibigan, yung kalabang kasi ng Bicol University is one of the top contenders talaga dito for LCL.
Ulitin ko lang guys, ha? Top contender.
Top contender. Yun po kasi yun, sa dito, hindi lang para sa South Luzon Conference, kundi sa buong LCL.
Sa title mismo.
Sa buong LCL. The main reason why napigil yung kanilang advance in the previous term of LCL back in 2016 summer is because the mid laner here of UPLB, Honor at Excellencia, Eminem, which is a Korean by the way, got banned.
Okay.
Oh. So, ayun. But of course, the thing about that is that may option sana sila na mag-sub. Pero same as with the code na Honor and Excellence ng UP, sila go big or go home sila. Okay, they have the option to use a substitute pero they did not, so go big or go home, and they choose to go home.
Okay. Well, at least they respect the
but mid lane. We know someone who's going big for today's episode.
Yes.
Yung nanalo ng ating search and win trivia. Of course, ayan po, the biggest congratulations para kay Joseph Pagel. Ayan, mula sa college level po siya, of course ADC main siya. And take note guys, di ba meron tayong hindi na-announce na winner
noong
game 2, tapos meron ding game 3. And the thing there is that siya rin po yung nanalo.
Oh, wow.
Doon sa game 3.
Double kill.
Yeah, he's a double winner for today. Ayan po, kaya nga sinabi natin, go big. And the thing about that is, yes, ganun siya ka-skilled and ganun siya ka-anticipating sa ating search and win trivia question.
Inaabangan niya,
may naka-reading tab po yan. Oo. Yung question number 1 is, ano yung unang Drake noong game 2? That is an Infernal Drake. And of course, yung question naman for game 3 was ano yung mastery level? Ano yung mastery level nung Bard sa game 3, which is mastery rank 7. Yung sa game 2 po, unang Drake is Infernal Drake.
Yes.
Now, as quick story lamang, hindi talaga siya yung nauna.
Yeah, hindi siya yung nauna.
Ano, sa game 2 question. Ang problema lang, yung nauna,
Mali
yung sagot.
Minsan talaga pag una, hindi mo alam kung mali talaga, ganun.
Siya yung ikalawa at tama yung sa kanya. So, the second time around.
The second chance
po yun magkakatalo mga kaibigan. And let's see the second chance here of Bicol University Shave. Discussing the bands here, we have the Gangplank, Ivern, Rengar. Bands dito ng UPLB, LeBlanc, Graves, Queen. Initial thoughts, Alpha?
Well, of course, LeBlanc, 100% ban rate all across all regions.
Oo. So, most sobrang, ban champion.
Sobrang nakakatakot.
Despite the nerf
and
on the passive.
Yeah, na-nerf siya, pero yung passive lang. So, it means that ganun pa rin siya ka-threatening. Mm. And going in or moving into the 7.4, wala pa rin plans itong si Riot to change anything from LeBlanc. So, anticipated na yun. First ban always goes to LeBlanc. Mm. And respect pa rin kay Rengar kahit na-nerf yung Q niya.
Uh-huh.
The distance nung Q mismo. And kay Ivern, even though na-nerf si Ivern, ang nerf kasi sa kanya kay Daisy, well, actually, this nerf naman kasi is not stated mismo sa skill description ni Daisy. Walang nakalagay doon na nakakapag-regenerate siya out of combat. So, ngayon,
consistency. Talagang,
yeah, tinanggal talaga nila yan.
Inalis talaga yung regeneration out of
combat. So, wala talaga siyang totally idea on that one.
There's a nerf as well on the tankiness ni Daisy.
Ni Daisy.
Pero, actually, yung power kasi dito ni Ivern doesn't just fall on the Daisy. It also falls on the brush maker.
Yeah, the brush
maker. The idea of taking objectives inside the brush.
At saka yung range kasi, talaga sobrang nakaka-hurt sa kanya. Yung trigger seed, ito pa pala guys, about the trigger seed, it can be used for only 2 seconds or 2 to 3 seconds. Lagyan mo ng chalice, lagyan mo ng redemption, lagyan mo ng ardent sensor, I think. Oh. So, from that point, may aabot siya ng 1,500 health. Nabigay.
Na shield ba? Kung baga na shield. Oh, na form of shield. Oh.
So, isipin mo kung gaano. Oh.
Ano siya eh, ang pa-classification ni Jad kay Ivern is, he is a high gold support.
Yeah, sobra.
In the jungle. Now, again, we are on our loading screen. And again, as I've mentioned back in Game 3, isa po sa newest pick-up in the lineup of UPLB Excelsior is Daigo, a substitute.
Oh.
Now taking the position of the top lane in this game, rolling at Darius. Napaka-formidable na pagbabalik ni Daigo dito.
If you guys are not familiar with Daigo, Daigo is the former mid laner of Team Naga. He is one of the best Azir and Yasuo player way back 2015.
Nung panahon niya sa PGS, ex-PGS player po yan. Star player, to be specific. Yes. If I'm gonna compare him, kahit kino-compare natin siya sa mga katulad ng jungle nila Veer, o kaya ADC, Berserk, o kaya ni Neep na support and iconic na top laner, eh, and support for this game, for the XPGS yata on LCL, even against Raze, I think Daigo is the most, may pinakamabigat eh. Pinakamabigat na pangalan na XPGS na nasa LCL ngayon.
Biglang bumisita.
Oh, nasa LCL na kaya lahat po kami. Eh, sorpresang sorpresa. At hindi lang yun. Daigo right now is a heavy contender as well in the top one solo queue spot.
Challenger.
Oh, sa Challenger. Ayan po mga kaibigan. So ngayon, oras na. We are on Game 4. This time, it's gonna be Bicol University. Shave versus the formidable, you know, second time nila sa ating LCL, but they are clearly a threat. It is University of the Philippines, Los Baños, Excelsior.
Yes. So, medyo sabihin na nating
may first blood kaagad yung
oh,
yung Excelsior dun, man.
It yung, means that the death sentence was hindi ko na maximize yung death sentence.
All of them has the assist as well.
Oh okay. And yung kills na punta sa Kha'Zix.
Oh.
Kha'Zix to. We're not just talking about Slain, kundi kay Kha'Zix mismo na jungler na pag nag-snowball is really a huge. So yan, so on the replay, that sentence plus the
oh my god,
connection lockdown is able to secure that kill.
And max range that sentence yun. Catching Janna fresh from the waters. So right now, that kill would allow an extra longsword for these Kha'Zix. At mukha lang yan, first item na chepi-chepi lang.
Oo,
pero malaking bagay po yan para sa first gang.
And he didn't opted for the machete. Yung talagang gusto niya ng raw damage na magagaling sa kanyang Q.
Of course, mana for the Q as well. Yun yung nabibigay ng jungle item na yan, initial jungle item na yan. Ladies and gentlemen, so right now, knowing that there's a lot of kill threat available for these Kha'Zix, it would be a play for the jungle, really.
Yes. Ang maganda rin kasi doon, what did Benz do is, hindi siya kumuha ng skill agad. Ginamit niya yung Deadly Flourish para doon sa snare na magiging connection ng death sentence. So, sobrang daling na i-lockdown.
Grabe yung lockdown.
Ni Janna doon, ni Frenchie. So, yeah.
Yes.
Good play from UPLD. Pero right now, they are just trying to farm it all off and talagang usong-uso ngayon si Varus, no? Pero right now, UPLB opting for a really high-powered. And that sentence was able to connect that with Flourish.
Oh,
also,
this clip is going so low here with Dash going all in.
Wow, Dash.
By the Jin, flash in by Dash. And one hack and slash gets the kill against Discrepancy.
Grabe. Nagkagamitan ng Ignite.
Oo, at nagkagamitan ng Flash dito. You can see they are clearly ignoring and have a good sense of targeting. Well, you can see na wala, hindi malang nila pinansin si Prajis dito.
Ooh.
Now it's gonna be Slain visiting this top lane, ladies and gentlemen. Apprehend on the screen goes flash in by Slain. One final Darius. Of course, decimate, but it's gonna be Kha'Zix kill. The longsword manifesting itself in the body of these Squid Goals. Trundle. Well,
this is the early aggression coming in from UPLB at hindi na question kung bakit isa sila sa mga number one contender ng LCL. Kitang-kita nyo naman guys, hindi pa tayo umaabot ng 10 minutong scoreboard
they
natin
are.
Ay 0-3.
Sa conference na to, if we're not mistaken, back in 2016 summer, they're the top two. On this conference, they're the top two. OLFU, kasama ang OLFU.
Oh, okay. So powerhouse pala talaga ang conference natin ngayon.
At mamaya, yun yung laban talaga natin. Deathmatch po ito, mga kaibigan. OLFU, Profilers of the Unknown.
That's
versus,
the last game, right?
Oh, yeah. UPLB Excelsior. So, ang malaking tanong dito is, ano yung pwedeng gawin ng Bicol University Shape? Because it cannot be denied that this is their biggest challenge here in LCL. Mm. Hindi lang yan so far, ha? Ito talaga yung biggest
ito
challenge nila.
Ito yung pinakamalaking stepping stone
nyo. Oo, na pwede nilang makuha sa LCL, sa dinami-dami ng pwede nilang makalaban. Ayan.
Tipo kung gusto nyo mag-hiking o mamundok, ito na yung laruin nyo. Kalabanin nyo UPLB, mamumundok kayo. Oh, sa sobrang hirap.
Medyo, sa totoo lang, LB talaga bundok.
si nung ito, share lang, quick story lang, kumbaga, si Nip Eno nakalaro natin. Hindi ko alam kung naaalala mo. Mm. Tayo yung hindi challenger, biglang sumali si Nip. Napakyu tayo sa mga bundok. So, ang hirap po yung kalaro
ni Ang hirap nila abutin, mga kaibigan. Ayan. So, ayan. And in an instant, you know, wala pa tayong 5 minutes. Pero mayroon ng tatlong kills dito, ang Excelsior.
And going back, top lane, in over natin, Daigo, he knows na he has the damage and opted for Ruby.
Yeah, you could see there as well na walang Ruby idea dito. Ang UPLB, sneaky setup by the Lee Sin on this side brush. It's a matter of time, really. They could actually bait in a death sentence.
Walang summoner spell, kundi heal lang ang meron sa bot lane na to. So this may be a possibility for a kill, pero the Waves is really pushing in. That's a 4 range minion against this 3. So, feeling ko medyo mapupurnada to.
Oo.
Kasi it's really bad if you go that deep without any visions dun sa jungle na nag-rotate na. Oh, that's another kill from Daigo. Exchange kill pala from Daigo.
It's a 1-for-1. I'm trying to look dun sa skull mark nung kill na yon. And I think hindi naman tower dive yon.
Yeah.
So, yep, it's a toe-to-toe fight between the two.
Oh. And I'm not really sure bakit sobrang... I mean, mahirap talaga lumaban sa Darius.
Oh.
It's just that you have the sustain, you have that corrupting potion, pero Daigo is still a pain. Oh. Ano yun? So,
actually, malaking threat dito is that 6 minutes pa lang. Actually, wala pang 6 minutes yan. May Caulfield Summer na yung K6 natin.
Yeah, at saka kung titignan mo, si Iconic, when he played at Legion, he's rolling that Darius din.
Oh.
So, I think feeling ko ang UPLB is formidable players na talagang nasa sistema si Darius. Kasi talagang malakas naman siya. Pero if you're going to check other regions, medyo hindi maganda. Pero Stancing Mace, Storm has been...
Yes, Lane going all in onto Eminem. Ooh. Puts down the exhaust, one final hit, isang Q na lamang na nasalo dito ni Slane. Actually, hindi talaga tumama kay Eminem. Wow, that is a close call. Nice gauge there by Red. Had it been na nakahabol ang isang kitlat ng Slicing Maelstrom dito kay Eminem.
Hindi si Eminem, mabilis mag-rap. Eh. Naka 8 mile si Eminem.
Very likely that Rain will bag in that kill in the mid lane. But of course, Slane is gonna be here. Of course, gonna soak up the experience from the minions. Making sure na walang masasayang and at least walang pressure na maibubuo dito yung mid laner ng BU Shave.
Have you heard the news na magkakaroon ng rework si Aatrox?
Yes.
That's one of the latest news from Riot na they're really looking into. Pero
may na siya, may t-shirt na siya.
Yeah, pati si...
Or may shirt na siya.
Para ano naman, no? Sobrang laki kasi ng katawan niya.
I recall Kairu really mention kung gaano ka-awkward talaga yung kit ni Aatrox. Kaya walang masyadong pumipick up talaga sa kanya pagdating sa competitive.
Pero way back talaga, naging highly contested siya. It's just that as day goes by, o kaya as the meta goes by, sobrang nagbago or may mga mas better na.
Yung mechanic kasi nung kanyang Bloodwell, if I'm not mistaken, na passive, as mentioned by Kairu dati, ano na pag-uusapan namin yan, it's very awkward daw. of course, in a sense na hindi pasok yung kit niya and doesn't go in unison with his passive ganun. Of course, he's a duelist tapos ganun yung passive niya, parang hindi pasok na pasok daw. Ayan. So, now back into this game, you could see there that there's a 2k gold lead here by UPLB Excelsior. So, despite their lead, our game has taken steady pace.
Oh, Charm has missed. Oh, possibility to mag-go dito si Rain. Nalukat down ng Charm. Oh, wow.
Ah, knowing that Charm is not available as well, one final hit and that's how it is done. Sidestep pa balik, grabe. Flash in. Tapos,
the fake, the pump fake.
Oh, rush. Oh, electron
rush.
Lightning rush.
Yes, the lightning rush, of course. From the top lane.
And the top lane now. There's 2% here by UPLB.
Oh, wow.
We'll see the kick onto Daigo. One flash in. And di nga kinailangan malagyan ng Q doon. Clearly, a sabotage here by Starpin against UPLB. Garden call by UPLB. All bullets.
Oh, my.
Finish him here. Oh. By franchise. Nice heal. Reach allowed movement speed. For the sidestep there on the fourth bullet. Pero, you know, clearly it's a miss as well on that fourth bullet. UPLB. This is clearly a nice retaliation against the formidable team.
Yeah.
Bicol University, rather. Against the formidable team, UPLB.
Grabe yung pasok ni Sturban with a very good Flash Dragon's Rage combo. Para ma-airboard.
Ang ganda nun.
Isipin mo, if I'm not mistaken, ang na-airboard dun si Daigo. And you are running a full health. I mean, you have the full tankiness and with health kay Daigo. So it means yung health point damage niya is tumama kay Slame.
Yep.
So the damage, double damage, and then a good finish coming in from Squid Gold with that Q and auto attack reset from Chamath. So, yeah, very good play.
And to mention as well na may isang full minion wave na lamang dito si Rain against the Ahri. You can see that the proto belt is now completed.
One of the assassination items dahil may damage din talaga to.
Lightning rush. And
with that, really hurts you a lot.
Naalala ko nung hindi pa ninerf yan. Ang laking pickup niyan pag likes of the Lissandra. Gives you a really nice utility.
And kay Elise, no? Kahit jungle, Elise talaga meron dapat yun. Sa extra range. I mean, from that, pero yun nga sa bot lane, it was a close call as well. Pero yun nga, fourth bullet coming from that beating ball talaga.
Beating note as well. Ultimate as well of discrepancy. Connected. Okay, dito kay Benz. But you could see that Bicol University Shave has an idea that members of UPLB are converging here. Now they get a side onto the Kha'Zix. Nice sidestep there to disrupt and not receive the charm. Take note that the slicing maelstrom is still available, guys.
Wow, BU on the, sobrang aware sila sa nangyayaring galon ng UPLB ngayon na medyo itong formidable players or itong bundok na to medyo inaakit ng BU.
Makikita mo dito na kung ano yung nilamang nila sa early game eh hindi nagre-reflect ngayon 11 minutes into this game.
Well, I think that also affects from the draft coming in from that Lee Sin. Sobrang early pick niya kasi. Sobrang flash into the boss rush.
Flash in! Proto belt damage!
Turnaround!
But of course, the pulse of that slicing maelstrom. Deja vu, another kick onto Daigo. Palagi na lamang sinisipa.
Wow.
At isang hagip mula kay Squid Ghost, Sturban, and Squid Ghost Synergy will definitely stop the king of the mid lane now in the top lane.
Wow, good play coming again from Sturban. So sa tingin ko talaga, kitang-kita yung lakas na kayang dalhin ngayon ng ni Rain plus the power from Sturban.
But of course, UPLB, they know how to react from that play, knowing that the jungler is up top. Let's go for the Infernal Drake.
Okay. Yes, and then feeling ko UPLB is trying to invest on moving further sa game kesa kunin pa rin yung early game advantage.
Yes.
So right now, maganda rin medyo. Wow!
Sentence! And that opens up for all of the bullets of the curtain call na hindi kailangan yung third bullet. Ladies and gentlemen, that's how it is done, shown here for the bottom duel of UPLB Excelsior.
Grabe si Dash. Really open flash, dead sense, dead sense confidence.
Nag-flash pa talaga siya, doon ako nakilis.
Siguro max range, I'm not sure, pero grabe.
Plus he might be anticipating the flash of the Baru, so.
And yun nga kasi, sobrang, kahit sabihin mo sobrang immobile ni Varus yung Chain of Corruption pa rin. Eh. Baka kung nilakad niya yun, baka bigla na siyang Chain of Corruption. So at least, pang surprise din talaga. Pero talaga nasusurprise pa rin ako sa damage ni Rain.
And Eminem, may ano ah, grudge engage dito kay Kennen. Ginaya niya rin.
Oo, pero
yung turn flash, rush, tapos ultimate.
Fox rush, pero hindi sapat yun. Lalo na sa rocket.
Oo.
Kasi pwede mo rin gamitin yung hex tech para pang sidestep eh.
Oo. Anangyari nga pa doon is si Rain willing siya i-take yung trade na yun. Yeah. Because he knows that he got the damage bigger than Eminem. Yeah. Anangyari nga lang, yung protobelt na rockets hindi nag-connect, pero still the damage from the slicing
mills
from
just grabe yung damage sa slicing mills. So, dati kasi paunti-unti like every 3 seconds. Ngayon kasi every second talaga. So if you stay longer on that one, talagang mas masakit siya.
The damage is invested more on the later part. Now here we go, playmaker by dash, two-man play, but here comes BU to disrupt everything also with a teleport. Things looking so bad for the support of UPLB as four members, the squad here mula Bicol Albay will make a scrimmage successful in this bottom lane. They're gonna aim for a push.
Kami nakakatawa, pero right now, nagkakapaan itong team sa mga.
Face check mga kaibigan, may protobelt pa po to. May Kha'Zix din, walang idea si Rain dito. But of course, he will get a stun, gets the kill, and a flash out. That's how he's stun. Shown to us by the Kennen, wow.
Grabe. Rain single-handedly. What? But here comes a curtain call. Lightning Crush. But you can see here, Lee Sin Stebbins trying to chase Slime. He has been used as well. But that's a sneak escape coming in from DPU Shave.
Grabe. Just yung Kennen, man.
Mr. Rain.
What a god. This Kennen. 3-0-0. Ang galing-galing.
And yung rotations talaga ni Stebbins. Like, hindi mo talaga alam kung nagkakataon lang na nandun siya o nandun talaga siya.
What the hell is this LCL game? Clearly, what we know is being challenged right now. UPLB's on the ropes for this game. It's a 2K gold lead here by Bicol University. Next Drake would be available is another Infernal Drake. Right now, with this kind of lead, Bicol University is poised to take that second Infernal Drake. Make the trade 1-1 in terms of these Infernals.
Yeah, lalipat ngayon is 7-5 na. Kanina sila yung pinaka-behind. Early game was tough, but right now, they are dragging it into the mid-game ng mas may items.
On a Trundle and even on this cannon, wow.
Yeah. Ang ganda rin kasi ng call na ginagawa ni Squid Golds na ginagamit niya muna yung ult ni Trundle and then he calls for help na kay Sturbed, which is sobrang nananigit yung power ni Darius.
Did it connect? I think it connected.
Yeah, it connected.
It connected.
It's just the lantern.
Sana ka, okay. Ayan.
So, feeling ko sa animation nung
Chain
of Corruptions.
Na pwede parang mo pala maklik yata, pwede mo pa pala maklik yung lantern even if you receive the
coming from
corrupted chains. But that is a winner by UPLB.
Yep.
Flash burned on the enemy ADC. You see there's Feed Ghost setting up that death brush. You could see
si Rain dahil dun sa pagiging threat niya, it will be it will be difficult for UPLB para pasukin ni Kha'Zix.
But that is for the mid game,
Eminem.
But that is for the mid game. They may want to watch out for bends on this Jhin.
Yeah, okay. Kumbaga yung long range na yung aasahan nila. Pero you still have Trundle to body block everything. And you have also the Moonsoon for the regeneration. So, medyo challenging for UPLB if they want to assassinate someone.
And this is clearly a statement as well of the situation in the map. Right now, clear objectives from these two teams is gonna be the mid lane outer turret. Do take note na may lamang po ang Bicol University in terms of turret, bandang bottom lane.
Yes.
Okay, after that skirmish, after sending four members nga in that bottom lane and after they killed Dash with that aggressive engage. So, ngayon, mapapasin mo na yung vision dito ng UPLB. I heavily invested in the mid lane.
Yes. Yun nga rin na, Shinis, yung kay UPLB, since nakikita mo naman na mahirap na pumasok yung assassins, they need to trust Dash. Na parang what Dash can do is that he can use a death sentence, try to single them out.
Pero so far in this game, ang playstyle ng Bicol University has been reactive.
Yeah.
And makikita mo yung adjustment dito, kaya nag-tone down din yung laro. Kasi clearly, UPLB is making the necessary run-throughs kung paano sila mag-engage this time. because right now they cannot afford in diving this cannon.
Yeah.
Always and
they,
always.
They are really respecting Rain right now. And for the Infernal Drake, ito highly contested to. UPLB already has one. So, mas okay kumukuha na itong pangalawa, pero right now, BU,
Battle for Vision.
Yes,
battle for Vision for the Infernal
Battle
Drake.
For Vision at battle para sa Infernal mismo.
Yun yung malaking panong, mga kaibigan. Kasi, four members, really, heavily invested here in his bottom lane. Pero if there's gonna be a time to go for it, it is now. Because, by this time, actually, wala pang teleport. Wala pang teleport si, ano? Oh, this is a free Infernal Drake.
Wow.
Way by UPLB. Okay.
Well, at least it's 1-1.
Yeah, interesting. Interesting that they're giving away that free Infernal Drake.
Well, I guess talaga nag-tone down talaga sila. They greatly respected BU muna.
Ganun sila ka-respecting sa damage ng Bicol University to the point that they are willing
yeah,
to just
give up the second Drake.
Yeah, say let it be on the second Drake.
Oh, wow. Daigo.
This is very rare, seeing Daigo lose a 1v1 matchup.
Well, I think it also affects the ult from Thundel. Mm. So, kaya mismo si Darius napagod.
Not to mention, napagod.
Napagod, lumiliit. Kakaikot ng axe niya nung early game.
Energy deficiency. Ayan. Hindi energy ka pa. Okay. Iba yun, yung ano yan.
Yung energy.
Micronutrient deficiency. Labanan natin to. Ganyan yan, no?
Whoa, okay. Wow!
Ayun,
they were, wasn't able to finish.
Ayun yung nangyayari sa iyo. Yeah. Yung iniiwanan.
Yung pong nagsimula ka late na.
Oh.
Si iwan ka na lang.
Yung timing.
Yung aling mali ang timing. But right now, I am...
Pero ganun ka-conservative yung game ngayon, guys, ha?
Oo, medyo nag-tone down talaga. Kasi yung game yung tone down na, sige, bigay na lang natin muna.
Oo, sige. Sige, mag-ano na nga tayo, referral. Tapos yung referral, hindi na rin nakin ko-operate. Bahala
na kayo dyan.
Bahala kayong dalawa.
Wala naman kayong ganap, so okay. Kanina mo naman.
Wala namang ganap.
Wala namang ganap. Kanina, nag-aaway kayo. Ngayon, wala nang ganap. Uwi na lang ako.
Akala mo, may lakad lang.
Nagpamadali. Pero yun nga, item check from View Shave. You already have that redemption in the hands of Janna. Kay Franchise. And,
andito na si ako sa Pilot Hash. Pero rather, just in an instant, Rain not hesitating. In
see,
using his flash from the spirit
the
flash.
Threat coming from UPLB, it's Dash.
Okay, round 2!
Sabi na,
instant!
Correct on that one. They still need to trust Dash and do the pick off rather than assassinate.
Pag mind games ang usapan, doon nadadala yung UPLB. Pag nagkakaroon ng standoff. Yun din yung nangyari sa kanila nung game with MCL. Nagkabaron lang si MCL. Yeah, MCL, yes. Nagkabaron lang si MCL, hindi na sila naka-react ng maayos using their Malphite. And right now, eto, nag-group up lang si UPLB in the mid lane. And hindi na sila nakapag-coordinate ng engage.
Oh, that's the bad person.
Yeah, curtain call. Yep, just to be used defensively. Again, look at that, the damage that they can deal even without Kennen. So, sana hindi na lang tumayo doon si Rain.
Yeah, or dapat GP nag-rocket matagilid
pero I think dodging it. What I would commend there would be Dash
because he's been on point of mostly the sentence ngayon.
Yes, on point to burn a flash at least on Kennen, and actually nung second turn catch Kennen himself and kaya rin yung rason doon na nag-stay si Rain is because Starbin was on his way going for the setup. Kung makuha ni Starbin yung kick doon and get the attention of the most of the members ng UPLB dito. Wow, sneaky. Whoa. Okay. Hindi siya nakita.
Oh, there's...
Okay.
There you go. Pero yun, has been used and a deadly flourish. The burst damage from Slain was able to secure the kill. Pero yan na nga. Mukhang ito na ulit na nakikita natin na fall off.
Ang malungkot dito, mistakes to eh.
Oh, yeah.
Sunod-sunod na mistakes
to eh. It's an aggressive mistake. And kahit sabi mo ikaw si Lee Sin, it's not really good to farm on the other's team jungle nang walang good vision. So, saan sila, kung nasaan sila currently. Kasi naglagay siya ng vision, pero kung nasaan nakapwesto yung mga kalaban, no. So you can see a teleport.
Of course, there is a teleport. And for this fight, hindi nila makakasama kaagad yung Kennen. Una makakarating yung Ari, 3 versus 3 with ultimate of this. Varus receives the dead sentence, one flash in, and Daigo will now go down. But of course, in exchange for their own ADC, it's gonna be a 5v3, just quick raid. Will he aim for the dive? Will he be able to secure the kill? Will he be able to land the crowd controls in the backline? Here comes Lane, curtain call gets used. Bullets not connecting, and Lane is still able to survive. One final Q doesn't connect, only to the cannon. And that is, in the end, a win for UPLB Excelsior 2 against 1. In the back row, it is Excelsior's game.
Wow, good play. Ito na yung time na nabasa na ni MNM yung galaw. Yung rain na...
Yung, kung paano siya pupunta,
yes,
mag-rotate.
Yung mismong slicing maelstrom is nirespeto niyo yung range. Not really soaking up too much and tried to hit every charm compared on the first ones he had o nung mga laban nila sa mid lane.
At doon nahirapan si Rain, really. Nung natagpuan niya si Slain sa bandang right side jungle, and he knows that Ari could be anywhere. So, in the instance, nabasa yon ng Excelsior na hindi makakapunta kaagad si Kennen doon sa bottom lane. Teleport si Daigo. Go for the fight. 3v3 nga lang, pero it's very likely that no matter what, looking into the scenario, kahit ganun ka behind yung UPLB, it's very likely they win that. And dash again with that sentence. Look at that. Look at that, really. Had it been that Squid Goals received that death sentence, it would be more ideal for them. Pero really, for this case lang, nauna makakarating talaga yung Kha'Zix.
Pero yun, nagulat din kasi ako na kay yung Moonsoon. Nagamit siya, not really sure why, na parang wala. Hindi wala totally na maximize. Walang na push, wala totally na heal kasi ginamit lang siya ng sobrang short amount of time.
So right now, yung lamang kanina ng Bicol Shape, this time, it's gonna be UPLBC.
Indeed, they are always 2 points up when they gain advantage. Whoa!
Dead sentence! Homing mid! Fantastic! Opens up with a curtain call. First bullet did not connect. Make that the second gets the sight on the Janna. This could be a 4v5. They're just waiting out for Squid Goals to arrive. Paano makabuo ng Squad Goals? But will that be a signal right now? Naaurahan na po dito ng UPLB ang Bicol University. Right now, they are 5. Two engaged, two man apprehend, and the decimate gets offset by the Moonsoon. It's a 5v4, which is going to be won by the 4. As you can see, that Bicol University racks up the momentum. Double kill for their mid laner. Turret getting tagged here by Squid Ghost. Did not receive the void spike. Gonna destroy the mid lane out of turret. And it's gonna be a 3-0 exchange.
And not really sure what happened on that
one. Man.
Nag-make up doon yung power ni Franchise sa magandang Moonsoon. Denying the power or the dash coming, or the flash itself from Dash and Daigo.
Ayun yung hinahanap mong optimal use ng Howling Game.
Yes.
Stop the Kha'Zix leap.
Wow. Mid-air.
Mid-air. Ayan na po. 3K gold lead in an instant. 2/3 in an instant. And so, let's see. Yeah. Let's observe that one.
It was a good Moonsoon. Sobrang ganda.
The playmaker. The playmaker for that fight, it is Francis.
Yeah.
And sobrang
max range.
Gamit na, ang sarap tingnan nung ano slicing maelstrom.
Max range is discrepancy, and you can see slicing maelstrom sobrang nag-soak in the UPLB. Grabe yung damage na offer nun.
Naligo sa kidlat.
Yeah. And we're not talking about just a slicing maelstrom. Naka-abyssal center to. So yung aura mismo is a big X.
Walang ano. Walang Zonya.
Oo, tuloy.
Full damage, tuloy-tuloy.
Tuloy-tuloy tayo.
Void stuff yung susunod na bubuuhin, mga kaibigan.
Walang protect.
Wala. It's either go big or go home dead. Ang sinisigaw dito.
Si Vio eh, nag-go
big. Ng mga Uragon. Alam mo ba, little fan pa. Si Rico taga Bicol din. Si Gloco rin. Taga Bicol din. Ayan. Lahat ng mga maiingay. Taga Bicol, ganyan. Si Manjin,
napagkamalan lang.
Nahulog sa bangka.
Oo. So, napunta
sa Iloilo. Napunta
sa Iloilo. Ayun na ang ating search and win trivia.
Of course, Link. Sino kaya ang magwawagi dyan? Do take note, may mga hustler tayo. Mga kaibigan.
Na-type na to ni kanina.
Again, pro tip lang po sa inyo, sa mga viewers natin, magbukas na po kayo ng type. I-type nyo na yung ano, HTTP, ayan, /// tapos bit.ly, tapos / para yung last, ano na lang, yung last randomized characters or digits na lang and letters, yung characters, yung kailangan nyo i-type, di ba?
Oo, para pabilisan lang. At syempre, dapat tama yung sagot nyo, pero yan na merong...
Curtain call, unang pick up, lots of cooldowns being naliligaw used here by UPLB. Interesting, it's been a long time really since I've seen a game na binuhat ng Kennen. Huling game ko yatang nakita yung ganun, it was on Suzaku.
Yeah.
Pero, EGS. Oh, ang tagal pa nun at protobelt pa yun, hindi pa nanenerf.
Kaya okay. Medyo, lumaki na nga kasi yung pool ng game.
Tsaka nagbago talaga dahil sa lethality.
Yeah, nagbago yung lethality.
Yung meta ngayon.
Meron pa mga assassin, so talagang... I can't really expect a Kennen to fit in right now on this meta.
Okay, so right now, UPLB, they cannot really encash so much with their small victories. And they cannot really punish Bicol University for their mistakes. Only Vision on the Baron na nakuha nila doon after picking up Sturben with that mid lane. Right now, they still need one more item really to at least get an advantage or go toe-to-toe against Bicol University. Wow. Sayaw-sayaw lang si...
Sobrang ano ni Squid Goals. Sanky ako. I'm just going to dance here in the village.
I mean, I'm sorry. Hindi pala yung Void Stuff pala kay Ari. So instead, it's gonna be Abyssal Scepter, Rylai, then we got... may isang Amplifying Tomb na available para kay... there we go.
Yeah, there you go. Seeker Zonyas.
Okay, Zonyas. Yes.
Pero yun nga, mas kakabahan ako siya na sinabi mong Rylai sindala niya kaysa Void Stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Kasi, well, slow. Kung kanina...
Dito ka lang.
Kung kanina si Eminem nakakalakad pa palabas, this time hindi na. Kahit hindi sabi na mo mag-fox rush siya, magja-jogging lang
slow
si Kennen.
Andun pa rin yung slow, oo. And, ayun pa, hindi lang kidlat yung tumatama sa'yo. Giniginaw, kinukuryente ka na, giniginaw ka pa.
Grabe, no, parang dala niya yung buong Baguio pagka nag-slicing maelstrom.
Na may kidlat.
Oo. Medyo weather forecast yung dating. And ayun nga, going back into the game, we are equalizing the score when 30 minutes into the game and both teams are really sticking out and
lots of damage as well.
Damage, I mean 2k advantage in the hands of Biushi.
Lots of damage as well being brought into the table here by UPLB Excelsior in the form again of capitalizing what's hot in the meta right now. Infinity Edge on top of the Yunmus Ghostblade. Ngayon pa lamang siya bubuo ng kanyang Edge of the Night, which allowed for Varus to actually
protect himself.
Which allowed for Varus to actually at least not gain that much damage.
Ooh.
In the form na, in a sense na pinili niya yung Edge of Night early. Pero kasi yung muna mana, yung mana min, yan, na-proc na, completed na rin dito. So, the spam ability, the poke damage of Bicol University here is established. All the more that they are forced to be more aggressive. And ayun ang problema. If they are gonna be aggressive, if they're gonna be the initiator for this fight, they will be heavily punished. In a sense na merong Janna, di ba? Lots of crowd controls really coming in from this lady. And of course, yun nga, si Kennen, Rain.
So protect the Varus na yung dating ng team ko. Pero Speed Goals trying to be confident on this spot. Pero you can see na movement from other team or from PSG.
Yeah, ang dami nang nabuhos dito ng UPLB. But of course, the path that they took would be the safer one. So, magkakarisa tayo. Pero ginamit nila yung Blasting Cone. Speed Goals will be apprehended there. Onto Daigo, Curtain Call will try to displace members. Ah, in the backline, look at that! Oh! Thanks to Kennen! Rain is down a killing spree as he managed to destroy the Jin. And Yugojin still managed to survive. Resets, it falls into the hands of Slain. Daigo on a double kill, getting all the stacks, blood stacks that he has. He's now on a triple kill. Ah, tumayo lang siya doon. Okay.
I think kinatay niya yung lantern.
Oh, binibait niya yata tayo. Ayan, for the lantern, of course. Flash in there by Dash. And you could see that in end, despite the nice setup there by Rain, Daigo is now scaling into this game. What the hell is wrong with this game? We are seeing three Infernal Drakes.
Three Infernal Drakes straight. From four kills into the second Infernal Drake ng UPLB, this will catapult them moving into the mid game, investing on the late game with a pure damage from that assassin and kay Daigo mismo.
And the thing about this game is that Daigo's already with this kind of ganong klase na skirmish. Todo niyang naka-duel team doon. Although, wala nang subjugate kasi si Squid Ghost doon nung nagsimula yung laban na yon. So, that's one. Let's see.
Investment ng items ni Daigo. Naka-Black Cleaver na siya. So,
yeah, let's try na the replay.
Pero yun nga, replay. Full duel on the bot lane. Pero sobrang nag-invest ng oras doon. Yung three person kay Daigo. Pero yun, they're set up from frame. Decimating Benz. Sobrang ganda. Pero yun nga, they still try to go in, Daigo, with the duel. Talagang makikita niyo siya on the other side of the map. A good exit coming in from Slain. Maganda pagkakabasa na maligado na. Pero ayan, Daigos.
Uuwi na lang.
Mayat-maya, merong...
Uuwi na lang sa bahay, kakatapos na nga after shift. Merong mananagasan. Pagliko mo dun sa eskinito, may daladalang itak yung kapitbahay mo.
Yun kasi, I think it's a good and bad thing. It's a good thing that Train can single-handedly take down the backline.
Oo.
But it's a bad thing to invest too much on Daigo.
Oo.
Without really trying to take others first, the priority target.
Yeah.
Na nagka-problema.
Had it been discrepancy, targeting the tank.
Oh,
ma'am.
Here we go.
Is that the best target? Slicing Maelstrom in an instant would be activated, get sustained by the Monsoon. UPLB Eminem managed to destroy Sterpen, and this is going to be a 4v5 situation. Make that a 5v5 account mo yung GA dito ni Brandel. Pero, ayan. It's gonna be a Baron. Could be. A Baron could be. Oh, no. It's gonna be a recall. Reset tayo sa laban na to.
Pero yun nga, UPLB Dash once again trying to push further the advantage from UPLB. Grabe, ang sniper niya masyado with that second.
Oo, man.
Key person yung mga tinatamaan.
Ito yung magaling mamingwit sa campus mo. Diba? May mga ganun eh.
Boy.
Oo.
Ngayon, gusto ko yung death sentence.
Oh, no. Di ba trash main ka dati?
Oy, tahimik ako. Hindi ko alam yan. Yung mga trash main na yan, alam ko may isang trash main din dito sa prod eh.
Anyway, back into this game.
So, yeah, back into this game.
So, we got the Zhonyar's Hourglass completed now for lane.
I love Daigo being confident on this. Hindi ako mag-GGA. Mag-armor lang ako. Sige, mag-GA ka, Trandon.
Full tank. That's the problem really about Darius. And what makes Darius really, really strong is that in the idea na Black Cleaver lang yung kailangan mo.
Uh-oh.
Then you pick up full tank items na and you still deal crazy amount of damage.
Kasi nai-spam yung ano niya, yung skills niya. So
yeah, yung
that,
niya.
It keeps on stacking up with that negative armor. Oo, subjugate really lessens your health and puts you some slow. Pero still Daigo, with all of those armor, still.
Yeah. What a close game. You can see here na si Sterben dito is now falling off on this Lee Sin.
Not unless a very good amount of setup to finish with a very good slicing maelstrom.
Yeah, kailangan niya magkaroon pa ng, if I'm not mistaken, I would recommend GA. Another tank
if setup ka na lang talaga. Kasi you can really do something eh.
Oh, or even a Radwitz Omen really if you're aiming to give Benz a hard time.
Yeah, and Sterben, I'm not really going
and
to...
And Radwitz Omen also sabotages Daigo.
Yeah, and right now, kay Sterben naman, okay, bibenta ko na yung mobility. Kasi hindi na siya mahalaga ngayon.
Hindi ka na nag-roam.
Sa Mercury Treads.
Oo.
Or Ninja Tabis kasi grabe yung nangyayari.
Oo.
Yung damage output ng UPLB.
Or, pwede rin naman. I think the option to go na... There could be. This is something na risky naman. Build damage again on this Lee Sin and just assassinate the Jin in the backline. Ang problema lang kasi may Thresh. Ayun lang talaga. And
so, kapag hindi mo makikita mo sa one hit kill.
Pag hindi ka tanky at naka-receive ka ng crowd control kay Thresh, katapusan mo na. The thing here is that pwede siyang umasa para kay Francis dito.
Yeah.
Pero the thing about Francis is that she's already busy protecting his Varus.
Yeah. And yun nga, medyo mahahati nga si Francis dito.
It's
either you protect that Kennen in the middle of the slicing maelstrom with Sterben, or you really peel off for discrepancy. Yeah.
Okay. Go for the more standard approach for Sterben dito. Go for tank. Yeah.
Maging reactive na lang din siguro si Francis kung sino talaga yung mas kailangan niya protectan or out of position.
Isang malaking pagkakamali ang pwedeng magtapos ng larong to.
Oh.
Or this, we are in for a long game. We might be in for a long game.
And I'm really loving UPLB right now. Putting the bait or the brush place from that. Oh, wow!
That's how it is done. Will they go all in? Napaaga yung monster dito. In the frontliners, gonna be die. Go!
Chain of corruption!
There is no unison on those ultimates. This might be awkward for UP.
Wow!
LP, and as well for PU. Stain is getting the resets. And here comes the re-engage. Oh, wow! Eminem. Wala doon! Si Squid Ghost! Akala ko ba Squid Ghost tayo? Bakit ganon? 4-0 exchange, and that is clearly a punishable mistake capitalized on by University of the Philippines Los Baños.
And I think it's not really Squid Ghost's fault, but wala siya nun.
Oh,
it's just that the flash four-man play kay Dash mismo yung nag-open up ng laban na yun.
Pero yung paggamit ng ultimate sa tumodo sila doon.
Yeah, tumodo sila.
Dapat umatras muna.
The pressure. That was the mind game coming from UPLB. If you have an Ahri and Kha'Zix, talagang kahit ako, mag-umunsun agad ako once na may mahatak. But what happened was, still Dash was able to survive.
They should be able to reach every time they land the crowd control at wala silang napa, they land their ultimates at hindi nagiging kill yon. They should realize that they are in a very vulnerable position.
Yeah.
Ayun yung nangyari doon sa match na yon. If they reset, kung hindi sila nag-engage and they just take a breather, umi-steady lamang, it's very unlikely UPLB can close that game. Despite having the advantage on ultimates, kasi meron silang wave clear.
Yeah.
Merong napaka ang dali ng wave clear ng BU Shave. They also have poke.
Yeah.
So there's really no necessity to complete that engage. If you review that match, if you see that pag-check natin sa highlights, tingnan niyo po yung final fight. Lee Sin kick, tinulak yung nasipan ni Lee Sin, yun din yung inaman ng Chain of Corruption.
Oo, si Daigo.
Oo, and ayun, ang daming ultimates na nasayang. Oo.
I'm not really sure talaga from that four-man play.
Oo. Yung four-man play, I think it's very risky. Yung ginawa ni Dash.
Sobrang risky niya, but it was a mind game na may na-play. Then let's go with the reactive play, protect. That was too much. They didn't even wait for Kha'Zix to jump mid-air and denying
it. Alam ni Dash yun eh. Kasi alam niya na wala si Squid Ghost doon.
Yeah.
Automatic 5v4. Ganun lang ang running rule talaga. If you get the number advantage, asset it. Kung pantay-patay lang at number advantage lang yung kailangan nyo, then go for that fight.
Ang nakakatuwa pa nun, he did a flash play. Supposedly, ang una mong gagawin doon, hindi monsoon, hindi kick, hindi kung ano man, kundi chain of corruption.
Oo, chain of corruption.
Kasi asa harap mo na eh.
Oo.
Well, kung pampil rin lang sa mga assassin, maaasahan ko pa si Sturben, tsaka si Francis. So bakit tayo magbubuhos ng too much damage kung pwede naman natin pitasin mismo si Dash?
Here we go. Let's see. This is a violet bar. So makikita niyo po, this is not damage dealt to champions. This is damage taken.
And able to survive.
Oo, so you can see there na ang taas ng damage taken. Ang kasix po natin, mga kaibigan. Pero you can see na, of course, on Daigo. Attack is member.
Yeah.
Cannot be denied. Makikita mo yung damage taken though by the Thresh.
Ooh, Rain! Baba.
And you could see the damage dealt there by Rain. Clearly, a carrying member here of BU Shave. Now again, understanding that final fight, let's discuss it further.
Wow.
Yung Monsoon kasi, ginamit pang instapil for crowd control. Naging habit siya ni Francis. Now, the thing there is that you use the monsoon, siyempre gagamitin mo yung skill mo in an optimal manner. So, hindi advisable na mag-monsoon. Isang character lang yon, Howling Gale lang, zapat na,
yeah,
di ba?
Yeah, Howling Gale.
Oo, pero siguro, nataranta siya ako, tapos ayun, parang ginamit ka agad yung monsoon. And the thing about monsoon, what makes monsoon so nice as a crowd control is that kapag in-kill range na yung pinoprotektahan mo, monsoon ka lang, merong tulak.
Distance, may heal pa.
May heal pa. So yung heal yung hindi nasulit doon.
Yung heal mismo hindi na nasulit. Oh. And here's another thing. If you have the Fox Rush, napakahirap niyan tamaan ng Howling Gale o kaya ng Chain of Corruption. So, doon tayo gagamit ng pampil na pang AOE para sure na kahit saan pumuesto yung Fox Rush, yung Flash ni Daigo plus Apprehend is matutulak, surely. Yeah. So, it's really a bad idea to use it really that early. And then it was too much for Sturben to kick far away Daigo. Kasi may Chain of Corruptions pa eh. From that point, they can just single out someone and try to kill it. So yung setup mismo na wala din, na didn't give time for Rain to have a very good amount of setup and finish them all.
Yeah. Kasi entering that game, guys, the expectation clearly is that BU Shave is the underdog against UPLB Excelsior. Pero as that game progresses, sobrang built-up na built-up yung expectations in favor of BU Shave.
I commend them.
They are very poised to win that game.
BU is really commendable.
They are very poised to win that game, especially on range performance. Kaya every mistake there on that final team fight, it's very punishing talaga.
Yeah.
Ayun talaga why that game was lost there. Kasi on textbook, diniskartehan lang.
Ng
UPLB yung BU doon. Pero yung final fight, dinidiskartehan lang ng UPLB yung BU doon. Pero ang konti lang nang nakukuha nila ng UPLB. Pero yung final fight na yon, sunod-sunod yung mistakes na yon talaga. And kung madiskarte yung team, guys, they will capitalize on every mistake. Okay?
Someone for UPLB?
Well, you know, this is League of Legends. So, this is League of Legends.
Still, I mean, despite of all those the last fight's mistakes, sobrang commendable talaga ng BU for staying strong.
Kaya ganun ka punishing. Kaya ganun ka para sa mga fans, para sa mga viewers, and sa amin mga nag-commentate. Kaya ganun yung siguro some form of disappointment for those kind of mistakes. It's because there is expectations there. Yeah. Based on that performance. Kaya nakikita mo naman yung ginagawa nung Kenen. Diba? Diyos na, mga kaibigan. And that's gonna be BU's fair para sa ating South Luzon Conference.
Oh, yeah.
Still, may laban pa po ang UPLB Excelsior. Yan po ang huling laban natin. But for the next game, we'll have a new team to be introduced. OLFU. I mean, new team, pero old team na talaga ito. New team lang for this day. OLFU, Our Lady of Fatima University.
Another
contender. Profilers of the Unknown. Okay, magpapakita muli dito sa ating LCL facing AMA Bimonation.
So,
classic na laban.
Redemption.
Classic na laban to. We've seen this actually way back in 2016 summer. So, ayan. Sa mga viewers natin, sa mga summoners natin, tuloy-tuloy lamang po tayo. Do take note na meron pa rin po tayong search and win trivia questions na lalabas sa mga susunod naming game. So, muli, may po yung naging shoutcaster for this game. Ako po si Shinbo with 149. Of course, with me is Alpha, mga kaibigan. Lenovo LCL 2017 Spring Term. Of course, now on its week 2 and we'll be right back for game 5.
Ang kalaban mo.
Of course, there is a teleport and for this fight, makakasama ka agad yung Kenen. Una makakarating yung Ari. 3v3 with ultimate of this. Abarus receives the death sentence. One flash in and Daigo will now go down. But of course, in exchange for their own ABC, it's gonna be a 5v3. Just quick raid. Will he aim for the dive? Will he be able to secure the kill? Will he be able to land the crowd controls in the backline? Here comes Lane. Curtain call gets used. Bullets not connecting, and Lane is still able to survive. One final kill doesn't connect, only to the cannon, and that is
BOOM!
Two engage, two man apprehend, and the decimate gets offset by the Munsoon. It's a 5v4, which is going to be won by the 4. As you can see, the Puikal University racks up the momentum. Double kill for their mid laner. They're getting attacked here by Screen Ghost. Did not receive the points.
Blasting code.
Goals will be apprehended there. Onto Daigo, curtain call. Will try to displace members. Ah, in the backline. Look at that. We get it. Lane is now on a killing spree as he managed to destroy the Jhin. And Yuga Jhin still managed to survive. Resets. It falls into the hands of Slain. Daigo on a double kill. Getting all the stacks, stacks that he has. He's now on a triple kill. At tumayo lang siya doon. Binibait niya yata tayo. Ayan, for the lantern, of course. Flash in there by Dash. And you can see that in the end, despite the nice damage, target slicing Maelstrom in an instant would be activated, gets sustained by Munsoon. UPLB Eminem managed to destroy Sterbend. And this is going to be a 4v5 situation. It's not a 5v5. It's not real. They go all in. Napaaga yung Munsoon dito. In the frontline, it's gonna be Daigo. There is no unison on those ultimates. This might be awkward for UP.
Wow.
And as well for PU. Stain is getting the resets. And here comes the re-engage. Eminem. Wala doon si Squid Ghost. Akala ko ba Squid Ghost tayo? Bakit ganon? 4-0 exchange. And that
dapat
is
the pressure. That was the mind game coming from UPLB. If you have an Ari and Kha'Zix, talagang kahit ako, mag-moonshield agad ako, mas nangahata. But what happened was, Steel Dash was able to survive
they should be able to read that every time they land the crowd control, like, wala silang napa, that they land their ultimates, at hindi nagiging kill yun. At hindi nagiging kill yun. They should realize that